Hi everyone, I am back with a new video, how to configure the XB as RF so that they can communicate with one another or in a network in just few steps. This video will help you to design a wide range of network for your research project or for an industrial product. So here we go. As you can see, this is XB S2C by Dizzy. We take two XB for communication. This is XB adapter. This adapter is used to configure the XB. And these are also the customized adapter for XB designed by Nutty Engineer. Here I am using customized XB adapter. So I take this adapter out, but if you want to use it, then it's okay. I am going to connect the XB to adapter like this. Now connect the UART programmer to XB adapter so that we can configure it. Now it's time to configure the XB. So we need to install the XCTU software. Link is available in the description to download the XCTU software. Open the XCTU software. I am connecting the XB to my laptop. Click on Discover Radio Modules. As you see, it's display the list of connected devices. Select it and click Next. Port parameters will display. Click on Set Defaults and then click Finish. As you click Finish, it will prompt to search the XB devices connected to the laptop. As you can see, we got the XB that is connected with COM port 9. Select it and click on Add Selected Devices and then Finish. Now it has been added to the radio modules list. Now click on Zigbee module. Configuration will be opened. Now we need to update the firmware of XB. So click on Update. Select the product family XB24C. Select function set 802.15.4th and select the firmware version 2003 newest. And finally click Update. XB firmware is updating now. As you can see, radio firmware has been updated successfully. By default, this firmware will set the XB radio as an end device. Now configure the radio module. We set the channel to C. It's already set to C. Now set the pen ID to 1020 and click on the write button. It has been permanently write the XB radio. This is to remember that the XB radio that has same channel and same pen ID can talk to each other. They share the data between them. So we remember the channel ID and pen ID for the other radios. Now set destination address high to 0, destination address low to 1. And my 16-bit source address to 2. Don't forget to click right button after set the each configuration. Now scroll below. You will get CE coordinator enable. It must be set to end device as it already set on it. And below there is NI. Node identifier. We write here as end device. Once we click to write button, you can see that XB radio name is set to end device. We click on write radio setting button to write the setting to XB if we missed something to save. Now I am connecting the another XB to my laptop. Click on search option. List of connected XB displayed here. We select all and click next. Click on set defaults and then finish. It's searching the XB modules. We got both of the XB in the list. Click on select all and click add selected devices. Now both XBs are in the module list. As we have already configured the first radio, so we click on second one. Radio configuration has been opened. We change the configuration of XB radio. So click on update and select the product family as XB24C. Function set as 802.15.4th and firmware version as 2003 newest. Click on update now. As you can see, firmware has been updated successfully. Now set the channel to C as already set to C. Set the pen ID to 1020 as same to the last radio and click on right button. Now set destination address high to 0, destination address low to 1 and click right button. Set my 16 bit source address to 2 and click right. Scroll down below. You will get CE coordinator enable. Set it to coordinator and write. At below in NI node identifier, we write coordinator. We click the right button here. You can see the name of the radio has been changed to coordinator. Now our both XB configured as end node and coordinator. It's time to check whether they are communicating to one another or not. So as we have selected the coordinator node and click on console. And now click on open so that we can communicate serially with another XB radio. Now we click on end node and then click on open like this. I am writing the message in end device. Hi, this is end device. Let's see that coordinator received this message or not. Click on coordinator and as we can see, we received the message. Note that we can differentiate the transmitter and receiver message through the color of the text. The transmitter side message is in blue color and receiver side message is in red color. You can see the data alphanumeric as well as in hexadecimal format. Now I am writing a message from coordinator node to end device. Hi, this is coordinator. Now click on end device and you can see the message that was sent by coordinator here. Now I am removing the end device from XCTU software as I want to show you the communication between XB more clearly. I have virtual terminal for serial communication. You can download it from the link that is available in the description. Open the virtual terminal. You will see the terminal like this. I am adjusting the view of terminals so that you can see the live data of both XB at a time. I am clearing the serial console. Now you can see the view of both software at a time. In the virtual terminal, click rescan button to refresh the COM ports. Here we have only COM9 of end device because coordinator port is already engaged with XCTU software. Now click on connect button. Our end device is communicated with virtual terminal using COM9 port. So this is the transmitter window for virtual terminal. I am writing the message hello here. As you can see, the message is received at the same time in the coordinator. Now I am writing the message from coordinator. Hi. You can see the message is received at the terminal receiver window. Now you can use these XBs for your wireless communication. Both can transmit and receive data from one another. Just connect the RX TX pin of XB to another microcontroller's RX TX pins, and you can send any data from one end to another. I have another solution for you if you stuck somewhere while you are configuring your XB. So let's go. Connect your both XB to computer and open the XCTU. Click on discover modules and select both ports as shown here and click next. Now click here as set defaults and finish. Now discovery is searching for connected XBs with your computer. Select both of the radios, then click on add selected devices and finish. As you can see, both XB's radios are in the list. Click on XB that you want to design as end device. Now do one thing. Download the XB configuration files from the link that is available in the below description. Download and extract to the location where you can easily access. Now click on profile tab, select apply configuration files, go to the location where you downloaded the XB configurations file. Select the XB end device 2003.x pro file and click open. The configuration is uploading to the XB. As you can see, profile's configuration has been successfully applied to XB radio. Now this radio is become as end device. Now click on the another XB. Repeat the process as we applied earlier. Click on profile and select the apply configuration file. Go to the location where configuration files already downloaded. Select XB coordinator 2003.xpro and click open. It's start writing configuration to XB. Coordinator profile also applied to the XB. Now our both XB become coordinator and end device. Now test the communication. Click on end device, click on console and click open tab to start serial communication. Now go to coordinator. Console is already opened here. Click on open tab to start serial console on coordinator. Now I am writing the message for end device. This is coordinator. Click on end device and you can see the message that is received from the coordinator. Now I am writing the message at end device to transmit. This is end device. Go to the coordinator and see, here is the message transmitted by end device. So our XB are now working fine. You can use them as RF now to communicate between them. You can use it with any microcontroller. Soon I will make a new video that will show you how it communicate with Arduino customized boards, Atmega 16 or 32, and also with the Texas launchpad. So thanks for watching. Have a good day. Bye-bye.